The name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, through my faults, through my most grievous faults.
Therefore, I ask
the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin,
all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God
in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you,
we bless you, we adore you,
we glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ,
Only Begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied it in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the holy and righteous one and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me, O my just God. You who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him.
Lord, let your face shine upon us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
As soon as I lie down, I fall peacefully asleep. For you alone, O Lord, bring security to into my dwelling.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Lord Jesus, open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way, and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, Peace be with you. But they were startled and terrified, and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then he said to them, Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a host does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have. And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, Have you anything here to eat? They gave him a piece of packed fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witness of these things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, this is the third week of Easter. The miracle principle, Reverend Norman Vincent, he has introduced a theory, the miracle principle. What is that? The great promoter of positive thinking, Reverend Norman Vincent, is promoting positive thinking. Believed that one of the most wonderful principles known to man is called miracle principle. 6 words describe the principle. Expect a miracle, make miracles happen. You expect a miracle, make miracles happen. According to Reverend Norman Vincent, if you keep your eyes open expectantly every day for great and wonderful things to happen, great wonderful things will tend to happen to you. Yes, he says that. The great promoter of positive thinking. You expect, it will be happen. Every day you expect miracles, it will be happened. If one expects great things from God, one will receive great things from God. How nicely he says. If one expects great things from God, one will receive great things from God. If you expect something from God, surely you will be received, he says. How then can one go about expecting miracles and causing miracles to happen? How it is possible? According to him, the number one thing is to have a tremendous faith, a deep faith, a faith that is so positively strong that it rises above doubt. You should not have any doubt. You should have deep faith. He asserts that if we train ourselves to have faith in depth, we have to train ourselves to have faith in depth. Like other exercise, or other things, or games, or sports. So we have to train ourselves to have faith in depth. So training, so faith is also a training. So we should train ourselves to have faith in depth. It will release an astonishing power in our life to produce miracles. If you train yourselves to have faith in depth, it will release an astonishing power in our life to produce miracles. Indeed, there are some people who are figuratively swimming in a sea of the troubles. They are so discouraged and dismayed by so many things that it is impossible for them to believe that a life-giving miracle could ever happen in their lives. Yes, some people are always doubting, or always they have troubles. They won't expect miracles from God. For them, it is not possible. He says that. The disciples of Jesus who were devastated by the event of their Lord's passion and death were similarly troubled with doubts, fears, and despair. So the disciples of Jesus, they were not happy. They were so troubled. They were afraid of. They were despair. So in this situation, an Easter apparition was necessary to assure them of the reality of a stupendous miracle, the Lord's resurrection. During the troubles, during the fear, the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ strengthened disciples. To the frightened and troubled disciples who were incredulous of the beautiful reality of the miracle, the risen Christ revealed himself anew, opening their minds and hearts, instructing them about the Paschal event of his death and resurrection, and its implications in their life as Easter witnesses. They were afraid of that, they were so much worried. But once the apparition of Jesus had strengthened the disciples, we know that how they were bold enough to preach the gospel. They have troubles, but once they experience risen Lord, after that we know that what happened. They were vehemently preached the good news. They were not afraid of that for to anybody. So what is the message of, in today's gospel? Jesus says that, my dear children, don't be discouraged by your failure. That is a very good message. The disciples were discouraged since Jesus has died. So they were so much upset. But they were strengthened by the risen Lord, by the resurrection, by his apparitions. The same way in today's gospel, strengthen us. My dear children, don't be discouraged by your failure. Don't discourage like my disciples. You will be strengthened. So God is ready to help you rise again. So he is ready. Father, God, our Father, is ready to help you. So don't be discouraged. The book of Proverbs says nicely, the righteous one falls 7 times and rises again, but the foolish fall and do not get back up. Yes. The foolish man fall and do not get back up. But the righteous man, one falls 7 times, even 7 times, and rise again. So don't be discouraged. That is a strong message. Since God is ready to help you rise again. It does no good to become discouraged with the many problems that come our way. Instead, our Lord is regularly calling us to look beyond them to something greater. Sometimes you may meet failure, you experience failure, but you can meet in features the great things. He is calling us to look his victory. Looking at his victory is freely and produces an incredible faith in our lives. You see the Jesus Christ, see him, his victory. Looking at his victory is freeing and produces an incredible faith in our lives. So on that, faith in the risen Lord will have the effect of a wonderful joy that God wants us to have. So that is very much important. So we should have strong faith, a positive thinking. You should expect miracles from God. If you expect, you can get it. So especially when we face many problems and crises in life, to stand firm in hope. The mystery of the risen Lord is about call to a new way of life. Even once you might have failed, but the new way of life is waiting for you. The risen Lord is about to call you a new way of life. Our God is ready to give you a new way of life. So do I be courageous to embrace the new way of life in the risen Lord? The risen Lord is in our midst as he was with apostles. Yes, apostles were so much afraid and discouraged, but his apparition, a risen of the Lord, strengthened them in the new way of life is given to them. So, especially in today's context, in his most holy Eucharist, he is strengthening us. Especially in his holy word of God, he is strengthening us. So we must believe that Eucharist, our Lord, the word of God. So let us not be afraid of this mystery. So reflect today upon your reaction to the reality of the resurrection of our Lord. Spend some time today gazing upon the risen Lord. Look at his victory. Look at his glory. Look at him who calls you to a deep faith with your eyes fixed on him. All else that tempts you to discouragement simply fades away. Look at his cross. Look at his victory. Look at his resurrection. Reflect sometimes. Then your discouragement simply fades away, goes away. My dear brothers and sisters, that especially we pray for that. Don't be discouraged always. God is ready to help you. God is ready to help us. Let us close our eyes. Just we pray to our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we do want to gaze upon you. We want to see your splendor and glory. We want to see you risen from the dead and take great joy and delight in this reality. Help us, dear Lord, to experience the incredible joy that comes from knowing you, our resurrected Lord Jesus. We trust in you. Amen. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnated of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess all baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead
and the light of the world to come. Amen.
We turn now to the God of Abraham and Sarah, the God of Isaac and Rebecca, and the God of all our ancestors in faith, who hears us when we call out in need.
For the church, that we may be compassionate and forgiving people as we preach repentance for the forgiveness of sins to all the nations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, that they may always grow in wisdom and insight, and that they may be committed to the truth as they exercise their leadership. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may open our minds and hearts to the truth that all people are children of God, so that we may fight racism, sexism, and any evil that mocks this sacred truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For farm workers and all who plant and tend to the crops that feed and nourish us throughout the year, that they may realize the fruits of their labors. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are preparing for receiving the First Communion, and for all of us when we receive the Eucharist, that we may know our Lord in the breaking of the bread. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the return of the good health for all those who are on our parish prayer list on the altar. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the repose of the souls of those who have died, especially Juanita Hernandez, mother, of Father Alfred, our pastor, Pat Binder, and Larry LaRue, and for the comfort and consolation of the Holy Spirit for their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all our own needs and intentions, especially the blessing we need most today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving God, you have blessed your people through all generations. Continue to bless us as we lift our needs to you. Listen to our prayers and grant our needs through your Son, Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the wine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
Regardless of the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for all our good.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your excellent church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up our hearts.
We lift them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain, who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was entered, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis, our Archbishop Jose Gomez, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of our mercy, you may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as you wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another our sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Lord of all, one call.
Praying. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh in the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, hope of the world. Jesus, light in our darkness.
Jesus, oh.